First, you must be much smaller. So this cup, each one of you, after reciting the mantras you need, you have to put 3 drops of water in the center of your palm, and you chant one mantra and sip it. Does everybody have their own? Actually, the second initiation is considered to be the confirmation of the relationship with the spiritual master and with
Krishna.
First initiation is said to be when the disciple accepts spiritual master. Second initiation is when the spiritual master accepts the disciple.
Казва, че първото посвещение е когато ученикът приема учителя, а второто посвещение учителят приема ученика.
Initiation, the word, means beginning. It should not be seen, the ceremony, as being some end unto itself.
Самата дума посвещение означава начало. Тази церемония трябва да се разбира като край на нещо.
Actually, the initiation is giving the opportunity for these devotees here to become liberated souls in Krishna consciousness and at the end of this life go back home, back to Godhead.
Всъщност това посвещение дава възможност на преданите да постигнат освобождение от Кришна съзнание и до края на живота си да се върнат вкъщи при Бога.
At the time of initiation, the force of karma, the momentum of karma, which pushes us to engage in materialistic affairs, is lifted from us. And we become independent from the material nature. But that is just to give us the opportunity to serve Krishna without obstruction.
и посвещени силата на карната, която ни потихва да извършва материални дейности, се отнема от нас, но това става единствено, за да можем ние да се ангажираме в духовни дейности.
When we say that one becomes independent of the material nature, it does not mean that one becomes independent. We are always dependent, but we become dependent now upon the spiritual nature.
Ние ставаме независими от материалната природа, но това не означава, че ние ставаме независими по принцип. Ние винаги сме зависими. И сега след посвещение ставаме зависими от духовната природа.
The material nature is the nature of sense gratification of this physical body.
Материалната природа, това е тя включва сетивно просъщение на материалната природа.
In the material world, people work under this consciousness that I am the body and life is meant to enjoy this body.
Материалния свят, хората действат с тази концепция. Аз съм материално тяло и моята цел да се наслаждавам с това тяло.
And thus they engage their senses. In material sense objects, they try to squeeze pleasure out of matter.
И затова хората използват сетивата си, търсвайки материалните сетивни обекти, от които те се опитват да извлекат някакво наслаждение.
And this leads to karma bandhana, bondage of karma, whereby we are forced to transmigrate from body to body, life after life, in this material system.
Но това е карма бандхана, или работа в материалния свят, който ни принуждава да се зараждаме отново и отново в своя материален бандхан.
So initiation means spiritual birth.
Ако посвещение означава духовно раждане.
We've had so many material births. Now, with initiation, we have this opportunity to take birth in a purified body, which is suitable for serving Krishna.
И сме имали толкова много материални раждания, а сега с посвещението получава възможност да се родим на ново, на ново чисто тяло, което подходящо да служим следваме Кришна.
So in this birth, this spiritual birth, the spiritual master is the father, and the Vedas, the Vedic knowledge is the mother. So when one takes this spiritual birth, this spiritualized body, then all opportunities are there to please Krishna, please the spiritual master, and leave this material world forever, go back to the spiritual world. In other words, to fulfill the meaning of our existence as spiritual beings.
Този начин да се върне обратно при Кришна, т.е. да изпълни истинското предназначение на своето съществуване като духовно чисто същество.
Шрила Прабхупада compared this opportunity to the building of a fire.
Шрила Прабхупада сравняваше тази възможност с палене на огън.
In this example, the fire represents pure devotional service. Which is our natural spiritual state. The wood, the dried wood, represents the purified material body situated in the world of goodness. The spiritual master is the matches which are needed to start the fire. And water is Maya.
дадете внимание.
So, if we allow my association with the spiritual master, who is fiery by his own quality, if we allow the wet wood of our body to dry, wet wood means that within this body there are so many materialistic tendencies for sinful activities. But in association with the spiritual master, with his fiery or Krishna conscious nature, then that water or that maya is driven out from this body.
Ако ние позволим на нашето тяло, което е като мокро дърво, мокро от многобройни материалистически склонности, желания за греховни дейности, ако ние позволим на това дърво да изсъхне в обществото, чрез общуването с духовно учение, което по природа е огън, т.е. Кришна съзнание.
So then, when the wood or the body becomes sufficiently dry, sufficiently situated in the world of goodness, then it will begin to burn. In other words, pure Krishna consciousness will manifest. So it's a very natural process to come under the shelter of the spiritual master, become situated in the mode of goodness, and then ignite our pure Krishna consciousness under the direction of Guru and Krishna. The drying out of this body means to follow the rules and regulations of devotional service. So the first initiates will vow to not eat meat, fish, eggs, not engage in gambling, illicit sex, intoxication.
Те, които получават първо посвещение, ще дадат обет, че няма да месо, яйца, риба, няма да правят хазарт, няма да използват сакраменти, няма да правят извънбрачните.
So they are expected throughout the rest of their life to maintain the principles of purity so that the body will remain situated firmly in the mode of goodness. Shuddha sattva, pure mode of goodness.
И те ще трябва да поддържат този начин на живот до края на живота си, за да могат да запазят тази чистота, равнението на чисто добро, Шуда Сатва.
So then, under the shelter of the spiritual master, it is very natural that the fire of Krishna consciousness bursts forth in the person of the disciple. Was situated in the mode of goodness.
Когато ученикът, който се намери в гъста на доброто, е приел послата на духовния учител, тогава съвсем естествено лудва този огън на Кришна съзнание в него.
But if the disciple again pours water on the wood, makes it wet, then the fire will naturally die down.
Но ученикът излее вода на този огън, то тогава съвсем естествено огънят ще гасне.
And then the appearance of Krishna consciousness will be delayed, hindered.
И тогава появяването на Кришна съзнание ще трябва да се отложи, защото е съпятство.
So if the disciple yet remains in the shelter of the spiritual master, again he will become dry.
Но ученикът все пак остане в каквото на духовни учител, дървото пак ще изсъхне.
But if again he pours water, then again the process will be delayed.
Но когато излее вода, тогава процесът пак ще се забави.
So this pouring water, this happens when the disciple is not careful to avoid the offenses in chanting the holy name of Krishna.
Това е изгибнено, когато става, когато ученик не избягва внимателно оскърбленията по време на подаване на Кришна.
There are 10 offenses plus one, which are listed in the scriptures. And one who indulges in any of these 10 offenses is inviting Maya to come and make him wet again, so that the fire of Krishna consciousness will not ignite.
Този, който си позволява, коя да е от тези, кое да е тези оскърбления, те просто си казва Майя да дойде и да не мога да дойде, за да не мога да се запали огън.
So, the first offense against the holy name of Krishna is called Sadaninda, or blasphemy against the Vaishnavas, against the devotees of the Lord, who are sincerely engaged in spreading the Sankirtan movement.
Първото скръпление се нарича Сада-нинда. Това трябва да се хулят вайшнавите, преднодарните, които искрено са се посветили на разпространяване на Кришна съзнание.
So one who takes a devotee of the Lord to be an ordinary person, an ordinary mundane conditioned soul, he commits this offense.
Този, който приема преднодарната Бога за обикновена личност и обикновено съзнание, той извършва това скръпление.
So he commits this offense if he judges a devotee by his birth. Just like in India, there one takes birth into different castes. But if a person becomes a devotee of Krishna, Vaishnava, then that consideration of caste no longer applies. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has stated, Naham vibro rajanara patir napi vaishnava sudra naham vani nachakriya patir no vanasatur yakya vakim prodhyam nikila paramananda kunamrita virgopi prakri kamam which means, I am not a Brahmana, I am not a Kshatriya, a Vaishya, or a Shudra. These are the names of the four main castes in the Hindu caste system, or Varnashram Dharma system. I am not a sannyasi, I am not a brahmachari, I am not a grihastha. These are the ranks within the Brahmana caste. In the Brahmana caste, the topmost caste, there are also divisions, so these are some of the
Това са степените в каста на Брахмана. Това не е личната каста, но не е също така и разделение.
So what does Lord Chaitanya say he is, if he's not these material designations?
Тогава, какво казва Бог Чайтанья? Кой е той, след като той не е тези материални обучения?
Рупи Паргамала, Даса, Даса, Амдаса. I am the servant of the servants, of the servants, of the servants, a million times removed. I am the servant of so many servants, of the lotus feet of the gopis, who are the dearmost servants of Sri
Krishna.
So this is the consciousness of the Vaishnava, that I am a servant.
Има това съзнанието на тези неща. Там ще аз не така.
So, this is how we should see the devotees of Buddha. They're servants of Krishna, that's all.
Ето този начин трябва да гледаме на преданите на Бога. Те са слуги на Кришна, това е всичко.
Not Bulgarians, they're not Gypsies, they're not Turks, they're not Hungarians, they're not Serbians, they're not Croatians.
They're not Bulgarians, they're not Zigani, they're not Bulgarians, they're not Serbians, they're not Croatians.
They're devotees of the Lord, servants of Krishna. Now, of course, as you see, these devotees are coming from a Bulgarian background. So obviously there is a material history behind them. But that material history, whatever it may be, however much foolishness may be found in it, that is not to be forgotten
forever.
We should never think of a devotee in terms of his past life before he took initiation into Krishna consciousness.
От тяхното минали живот, преди да получат посвещение.
And if the devotee has some difficulty in his Krishna consciousness, perhaps temporarily he may fall back into materialistic life and then return to devotional service. That also we should not take very seriously.
И също така, ако няма предан даден има проблеми в своето предно служение, известно време се върне обратно в материалния живот, след това пак Кришна съзнание. Ние също не трябва да смятаме това нещо много сериозно.
And if we see a devotee has some bad habits, because of his poor upbringing, perhaps he did not do very well in school, so he doesn't speak very perfectly, but we should not think critically of this.
И освен това, ако някой проблем от дарен има някакви лоши прилички, например, ако не са на възпитание, може би почитаме да се добре и това не говори много правилно. И никога не трябва да го критикуваме за това.
И Прабхупада said, we should have the mentality of the bee. The bee always looks for the honey.
Шрилупада казва, че ние трябва да имаме настроението на пчела винаги търси меда.
Because a devotee is a servant of Krishna, and Krishna's lotus feet are very sweet. So that means the devotee is also very sweet, just like honey. So we should become favorably inclined to all the devotees who are situated toward Krishna's sweet lotus feet.
Краката на Бог Кришна са лотосови и те са сладки като мен и те дадат, които слушат от лотосовите крака на Бог. Те също са много благи, те са също като мен. И с това трябва да бъдем много склонно настроени към всички преми дами.
But we should be like the bee and not like the fly. The fly, that mentality means he goes to the swords. There's some cut on the body, some blood is pouring, and the fly is immediately attracted to it. We should not have this fly-like
mentality.
The second offense against the holy name is to take the holy name of Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, to be the same as the name of any demigod.
Това установление спрямо святото име на Кришна, това да приема святото име за равностойно на името на който е Бог.
So all around the world, not only in India, but there are various religions in which different demigods or deities who rule the material nature are worshipped.
По цели свят, не само в Индия, хората обожават най-различните богове и други божества, обладащи материалната природа.
But Lord Krishna, he is Ishvara Param. He is the supreme lord of all these relative deities of the material existence.
Но Бог Кришна е Ишвара Парама. Той е върховният господар на всички тези относително могъщи божества на материалната природа.
Lord Krishna is the supreme form of transcendence.
Бог Кришна е върховната форма на трансценденталното.
And our relationship with Krishna is eternal because we ourselves are spiritual beings, his minute parts and parcels.
И нашите взаимоотношения с Кришна са вечни, защото ние самите сме негови вечни, безкрайни малки и отделими частици.
Our relationship with the deities, the demigods who are the creators and the destroyers this material cosmos, that is only temporary.
Нашите отношения с божествата, боговете, които създават и унищожават материалния свят, са временни.
So these demigods are compared to the leaves and flowers of a great tree, but Krishna or Vishnu is the root of that tree.
Боговете са като цветовете и листата на някое голямо дърво, но Кришна е корен на това дърво.
So somebody who thinks he can worship the demigods instead of worshiping Lord Vishnu is like a person who thinks he can water the tree by watering the root, the fruits or the flowers or the leaves.
И този, който си мисли, че може да обожава боговете, без да обожава Бога лично, това все една той доколива цветовете, клонките и листата на дървото, а не корен.
No, this is foolishness. If you desire to water a tree, you have to water the root.
Но това е глупо. Ако искам да полея някое дърво, трябва да полея корен.
So this is the Vedic process that all worship, all religion is ultimately meant for Krishna alone.
Това е ведическият процес, цялото обожание, цялата религия трябва да бъде насочена единствено към Кришна.
Although in the Vedic scriptures so many demigods may be mentioned, they are the angas, the extensions or expansions of Krishna's universal form. That's all.
Макар че в логическите писания са написани много богове, те са нищо освен анга и разширения експанзии на Вселенската форма на Бога.
Some people, when they hear this, then they think, well, if they are the angas, angas means bodily parts. So that means these demigods are the same as Vishnu.
Когато някои хора чуят това, те казват, добре, всеки тези богове са анга, ангата означава крайни.
So I can worship these demigods, and in this way I will worship
Krishna.
Because they are his bodily parts. There's no difference. But then this example is given, that if you want to feed your body, where must you place the food?
Но след това давам следния пример. Ако искаме да храним тялото си, къде ще сложим храната?
The body is composed of different angas, different parts.
Тялото се става от различни анги, различни части.
There's the eyes, there's the nose, there's the ears.
Очи, нос, очи,
So if you want to nourish this body, feed this body, if you take food and you push it in the eye, will your body be nourished?
Ако искам да нахраним тялото и сложим храна в очите си, ще достигнем това.
Or if you put it in your ear. The third offense against the holy name is called Guru Avagya. It means neglecting the order of the spiritual master, considering the spiritual master to be an ordinary man.
Третото оскърбление се нарича Гуру Авагия. Това означава да се пренебрегва наставлението на духовно учител, да се смея духовно учител, да се смея човек.
I explained this morning that the spiritual master is of course is not Krishna. He's never taken to be Krishna himself. But he's Krishna's representative in this world.
Тази утро обясни, че духовно учител, той не е Кришна, той не е равен на Кришна, но е представител на Кришна в материалния свят.
Just like if you want to deal with the government, so you have to deal with some representative of the government, some government officer.
Например, ако искате да се свържете с правителството, трябва да се свържете с някой служител на правителството, с някой да представител.
If someone says, no, these officers, they're not the complete government. I want to deal with the total government itself. And what do? You go to the presidential palace and talk to the building. I want to solve some of my problems. So I'm dealing with the government by talking with the big presidential palace or the Congress building. What is that?
Аз не искам да говоря с тези служители, аз искам да говоря с много правителство, с цялото правителство. Тогава какво мога да правя? Други да обощавам и да разговарям с градата на парламента, или пък така ще правя, аз не такъв и пред проблем, или пък отидете пред сграда на конгреса.
So the spiritual master, he represents Krishna in this world, and it is by his permission only that we are able to worship
Krishna.
So, the spiritual master should never be taken as an ordinary person. The secret of attaining full understanding of Krishna consciousness is to know, is to be firmly convinced that the order of Krishna and the order of Guru are the same, identical in every way. To those who have full faith in Guru and in Krishna and who carry out their orders with complete faith and devotion, then to them all Vedic knowledge is revealed. So the disciple is expected to honor the spiritual master and honor his paraphernalia, like his seat, his shoes, his vehicle. The spiritual master's picture is worshipped by the disciple as being non-different from the spiritual master himself. The disciple should be very eager to take the remnants of the spiritual master's prasad.
Ученикът с голямо желание приема остатъците от представения на духовен учител.
And to place the water that has washed his lotus feet upon her head. The disciple should offer his full obeisances whenever he sees the spiritual master. And the disciple should never discuss anything which is displeasing to the spiritual
master.
Another offense against the holy name is criticism of the Vedic scriptures, Shruti Shastra Ninda. And I said before, in our spiritual birth, the spiritual master, the father, and the Vedas, Vedic scriptures, are the mother. So, to understand the Vedic scriptures, one must follow the Sampradaya system. Sampradaya vinaye mantra nishkalamakaha. Unless one is in Sampradaya or specific succession, following an authorized school of Vedic study, one will get no fruit, get no result from his study of the Vedic mantras. So if we accept spiritual master, then from him we have to learn how to understand the Vedic scriptures properly. If we do not enter into the understanding of the Vedic scriptures, then we begin to speculate and find fault with the statement of the Vedas, thinking, oh, this cannot be right. This must be some mistake. That means we have not taken advantage of our initiation into the
Sampradaya.
Therefore, according to Sri Krishna, Bhagavad Gita, one of the very important activities of a disciple is to put questions to the spiritual master. If from his reading of the Vedic scriptures he comes to a point that he cannot understand, then rather than speculate and reject or criticize the Vedic statements, he should turn to his spiritual master in great submission, great humility. He should ask, what is the meaning of the
statement?
Now, an example of how one might speculate, one might criticize the Vedic scriptures, is if one reads the statements in the Vedic literature about the glories of the holy name, how powerful the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra is, and then he thinks, oh, this is exaggeration, this cannot be true.
Един пример за подобна ситуация, подобно съмнение. Това е, когато човек прочете в Ведически писания, но на същото въздействие от тази на Хари Кришна мантра, и Когато е просто кажа, не, това не е възможно. Това е невъзможно да бъде.
This in itself is another offense, a separate one of the ten offenses. It is considered so serious that it's in its own class of offenses. So the Vedic scriptures, they say, they tell us, that if one chants the holy name of Krishna, even once, he may be relieved of all sins that he's ever committed or ever can commit. So someone may think, but I chant in Hare Krishna mantra every day, so many times. And my mind is still influenced sometimes by sinful material desires. So how can this statement be true? It must be exaggeration. No, but the statement is true. It is explained that it is not necessarily true for everyone, but it is true for some personalities whose experience of chanting the holy name is described in the scriptures. Another offense against the holy name is to invent perverted theories concerning the holy name of the Lord. In India, there are what are called apasampradayas, or unauthorized sampradayas, which have broken away from the real disciplic succession. So they, among these apasampradayas, one will hear so many perversions of the philosophy of the Holy Name. One of them is that, yes, the holy name of the Lord is all powerful. And it is the only means in the age of Kali to become delivered. So we should depend only on the power of the Holy Name and nothing
else.
Anyone who is following Vedic principles has no faith in the power of the Holy Name. One who really has faith in the power of the Name, he will break all the way to and still chant Hare Krishna. In this way, you will be delivered by his strong
faith.
So, the real understanding is this, that the Hare Krishna mantra is Krishna, is full of Krishna's all potencies. So, because Krishna is the Supreme Lord, we have to be very careful, very respectful in our dealings with him.
Krishna is the Supreme Lord, and we have to be very careful in our dealings with him.
Just like in our dealings with fire. Fire is very powerful. Fire can do many good things. But if you're careless with fire, it will burn down your whole house. So one who thinks that he can deal with the Holy Name in any way he likes, engage in any sort of sinful activity, and still go on chanting, he will be destroyed by the power of the Holy Name.
Този същи начин, този, който мисли, че може да отнася към всяко име, така както намерим добре, че може да върши всякакви духовни дейности, които си пожелава, няма да ти ни към
себе. So that is also another offense, to commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting.
И това е още едно определение, да се извършва греховни дейности, като човек полага насилно на всяко име.
This is called Hati Sinan, the bath of an elephant. The elephant goes into the river and he sucks up water in his nose and he sprays it all over his body and it becomes very clean. But as soon as he comes out of the river, he takes some dust with his nose and he throws the dust all over
himself.
So, someone who chants Hare Krishna and in this way becomes purified, but then thinks, oh yes, now I'm pure, so I can go back to sinful activities and become impure, but I will chant again and become pure again. So he's taking this elephant bath.
И че може да започне отново да извършва греховни дейности и да се замърси, защото по-късно отново може да започне да натрупва и да се пречисти, те всъщност извършват на природни смъртни
практики. So the Hare Krishna mantra is not meant to help us enjoy this material world.
Значението на Хари Кришна мантра не е да ни помогне да се наслаждаваме от този време.
To get us out of this material world entirely. So one may try to enjoy this material world in a sinful way, and he takes to the Hare Krishna mantra to become relieved of sins. Or he may try to enjoy this world in a pious religious way. And he takes the Hare Krishna mantra as some kind of ritual which will help him go to heaven with his whole family and enjoy a picnic there for many thousands of years, eating nice mangoes and hearing the music of the Gandharvas and watching the dancing of the Apsaras. So this is another offense against the Holy
Name.
The Hare Krishna mantra is neither meant to help us enjoy this world sinfully or even piously. Another offense against the Holy Name of the Lord is to preach to and associate with faithless persons who have no interest in Krishna consciousness, or simply sworn to enjoy their senses in in this materialism.
Друго скръбление, между тялото има пад за общуване и вярване на личности, които нямат никакъв интерес към личното знание, към тялото и негово, които просто са приели обед да се наслаждават от това свят.
So we should, in other words, we should not maintain sentimental relationships with persons whose only business is to drag us down into Maya.
Ние не трябва да поддържаме сентиментални приятелства, сентиментални връзки с хора, които могат единствено да ни заобикалят долу в Майя.
We should not make the excuse, oh, I'm preaching to this person, and therefore I have to associate with him. But actually that person is not interested in our preaching.
Ние не трябва да се слушаме за оправданието, че проповядваме за този човек. И това трябва да стоим с него, защото един такъв човек изобщо не се интересува това, което ни проповядва.
But his interest is to engage us in material affairs.
Това по-скоро се стреми да ни ангажира нас в материални дейности.
So, a devotee initiated into the chanting of the holy name, he has to give up such company.
Така че, преданно даден, който получава посвещение,
The tenth offense is that is when one maintains attachments of I, me, mine, in spite of having heard so many instructions on this matter, in spite of presenting himself as a devotee of the Lord.
Десетото скръбление срещу тялото има. Това е човек, който продължава да поддържа своите концепции за аз, за мен, за мое, въпреки че чул толкова много скръбление, въпреки че се представя за предно тази.
This means we should not become proud of being the devotees of Krishna.
Това означава, че не трябва да се възгордяваме с предно тази на Кришна.
Pride means material identification. So to be a Vaishnava, a devotee of Krishna, that's the spiritual identity. So there's no pride
here.
But if one becomes pride, proud, thinking, yes, I am a devotee of Krishna, I am better than everyone else, then that is like throwing mud onto transcendence. So I have already explained, what is our real identity? We are servants, that's all.
И така, а вече без них, коя е нашата истинска самоличност. Ние сме слуги, нищо повече.
So finally, I said there are 10 offenses plus one. So the one, which is sometimes listed, there are different lists of the 10 offenses. So in some lists, this one appears, which is called pramada or inattention.
И както казах, има 10 скръпнение плюс едно. Последното скръпнение, което понякога се споменава дадено за света, но има различни списъци на скръпнение. Това се нарича правда или невнимателно казване.
So, when we chant the Hare Krishna mantra, we have to absorb our consciousness into the transcendental sound vibration.
Когато ни дадем Hare Krishna mantra, ние трябва да потопим съзнанието си
And then it will have very rapid effect in purifying us of all our material contamination and creating an attraction to Krishna within our hearts. But if we're inattentive, if we let our mouth run on like a tape recorder, but our mind is somewhere else, then we slow down the whole process.
But if we don't трябва да остане да се движи като микрофон. Ако остане като микрофон, а умът по това време скита някъде друга, това значи ни е много забавен целият процес.
So, we should be very careful not to be apathetic in our chanting, not to be lazy in our chanting, not to be distracted by other things around us when we're
chanting.
So, those devotees who are very careful to avoid these 10 plus 1 offenses will become firmly situated in the mode of goodness, Shuddha Sattva, and Krishna consciousness will soon ignite in their persons. And when Krishna consciousness ignites in your person, then you will be empowered to do real good in this world by spreading Lord Chaitanya's This is the only reason that the spiritual master accepts disciples, because he wants to see Krishna consciousness propagated throughout society. See, becoming a disciple of a spiritual master in this Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya is not like joining a tennis club or some other kind of mundane organization. It's not for sport, it's not so that we can feel good that we belong to a special group and we're different from everyone else. This initiation is an initiation into the mission of Lord Chaitanya. And that mission is dedicated to bringing the holy name of Krishna to every town and village on this planet. And putting one of Srila Prabhupada's books into every hand of every person on this planet. So now we will begin by asking the initiates one by one to come up and receive their beads and their names. So we have to move this table. Out loud. And then I will ask you some questions, which I hope you know the answer is good. And then you will receive your beads and your name, and then offer obeisances again and go back to the place.
След това ще получим своята поленица, своето име, след това много дали неща, свършите място.
So, first on the list is Bhakta Shtanimir.
Gottheit und der Song.
Next is Bhakti Plum. комунално зачакване. So your name is Pramasu.
Vasuman именно Кришна, което означава, че Бог Кришна винаги мисли за своите предни дани.
And now to the Mataji department. Bhakti Radhastina. Or you get to principle.